Okay, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to make a start, if I may. So, thank you for coming along to this first live lab session of today. My name is Steve Vaughan, so I'm the weighing sales director for A&D Instruments here in Europe. And I'm going to give a talk today about some new technology in our balances that is built in to help you determine balance suitability and also determine minimum weight in an automatic single button press way. So the contents of my talk really is just a very brief word on who A&D are, who we are as a company, what we do. A little word about balance suitability testing and why is it important and why is it necessary. What the conventional approach is using calibration weights. A word about our new technology using our patented ECL technology. A live demo of auto precision assessment using ECL technology on one of our new GXA balances we have here. Some benefits, and then of course time for some Q&A at the end. So just in case you don't know who we are as a company, just a brief word. So A&D Company is actually a Japanese company. We're headquartered in Tokyo. We've been in business for 40 years, and we're a world-class manufacturer of measuring, controlling, and measuring technology. Our company name comes from analog to digital conversion, A to D. So we were started in 1977 by a group of engineers who were experts in A&D conversion and started their own company. I've got a little video. I'm only going to show you just about a minute of it, but just a little intro to us as a company, if I may.
Measurement and sensor technology play an increasingly important role in business and science by connecting the analog and digital worlds. As a Japanese company that has been discovering precision since 1977, the A&D Group is working to create the world's most advanced technologies for measuring and analyzing critical data.
So I'll stop there for me, but if you want to see the full 5 minutes, you can get it on our YouTube channel. So choosing and specifying a balance. All of you, I guess, use balances. It's the most probably universal product in any lab, anywhere in the world, really. How do I know I've got the right balance for my application? How do I know it's suitable for what I want to work with? How do I know whether it's suitable for my balance to accurately weigh my sample? So it's not what the brochure says. How do I know if the balance is suitable actually to weigh my sample here in my lab today? And what happens to my weighing accuracy if there are changes in the local environment? Somebody turns the fume cupboard up overnight, or somebody puts the heating up 3 degrees, or it's a really sunny day or a really cold day. How do I know how accurate my balance, my weighing will still be in those conditions? So this is a question we get asked every time we come to exhibitions. Words to this effect, which is, so my sample only weighs 1 or 2 milligrams. So all I need is a balance that weighs 100 grams by 1 milligram, right? Wrong. The readability of a balance is not the same as its accuracy. So why is that? Readability is about whether the balance actually gives the same reading when the sample is repeatedly weighed. So if I weigh 100 grams 20 times, how often does it say 100 grams? How often does it say 99.99 grams or 100.01 grams? Something called eccentricity. How do I know, or how good is the balance, that if I move the weight around the pan, does it still give the same weight, plus or minus 1 or 2 digits? How linear is the balance? So does the repeatability and specification of the balance perform all the way across the balance's capacity from, say, 100, from 0 to 2 kilos, or whatever the balance capacity may be? And sensitivity, how well does the balance register small changes in weight? All of these are factors to consider when choosing the balance for your lab. But that's only to do with the design of the balance, what we do as manufacturers. What about things that are out of our control, but are in your control? So airflow, what happens if there's movement of air over the balance in the fume cupboard, or just on a warm day with the air conditioning turned up full? Temperature changes, what happens if there are significant changes in the lab? they could cause microclimate changes in a balance with a draft shield or breeze break, as we call them. What about vibration? What happens if you've got vibration running from a local bit of equipment, such a pump or a stirrer or something like that in the lab, which causes low frequency vibration? All of those are factors that have an impact on the quality of your weighing that we can't control as a manufacturer. We can give you some tools to help, such as anti-vibration filtering, but we can't control the actual environment the balance is used in. That's down to you, the customer. So what we talk about when we're looking at balance suitability testing is the standard deviation. Now, I guess we're all scientists here, so probably most of us know what standard deviation is, but just as a quick recap, a standard deviation is a measure of how widespread a series of data points are, you know, the typical Gaussian type curve that we see. But there's also a concept known as minimum weight, which is very, very well known for you in the pharmaceutical industry around the room today. And that really is, what is the smallest weight you should weigh on this balance to get acceptable, repeatable results? So my colleague says, if you try and measure below the minimum weight on a balance, it's like trying to drive your car at 1 mile an hour. You know, in theory, the car will do it, but it's going to be like this. It's a very difficult thing to do. And the consistency of speed will be very, very different, difficult. So minimum weight is a similar kind of thing. You know, above that sort of weight, how can we make sure that the balance is working and getting the kind of data that we accept? So minimum weight is defined by those of you that work in the US or work to the US Pharmacopeia. And what it does really, it takes into account the real world standard deviation in your lab, not just the specification from the brochure, but the real world minimum weight in your particular lab. And it's defined as 2 times the standard deviation times 1,000. So effectively 2,000 times the standard deviation of a series of weighings in your lab is the recommended minimum weight that's used on a balance. But how do you know what the standard deviation is? You can look it up in the brochure. But that is in an ideal lab, in a metrology lab, in a factory. What is the standard deviation in your lab on any particular day? So the way you do it, and I'm sure many of you in the room have to do this, the way it's done is to do a series of repetitive weighings. And because we're talking about the minimum weight, we're often talking about a series of repetitive weighings with very small weights. So typically very small milligram weights, little bits of metal foil, very hard to pick up, very easy to drop. It's even more difficult to do it if it's in a fume cupboard or a glove box where you're working inside a confined environment and you're trying to handle little weights. I see some nodding heads here. Yeah? It can take a long time to do because we're often required to take a series of 20 or even 30 weighings. The management of the weights requires care. You have to make sure the weights are stored properly, controlled properly. And there's human error because inevitably we're talking about a human manual process. So wouldn't it be great to have an automatic way of calculating minimum weight in your lab? Yeah? Well, that's what I'm going to show you right now. So we have a solution, and our solution is called Automatic Precision Assessment, and it uses something called ECL technology. And again, I've just got a short video to show you. So that's a little example of how the ECL technology works for automatic precision assessment, and we'll do a live demo in a second. But let me explain actually what's going on here. So how does ECL work? So this is a simplified view of one of our smart super hybrid sensors. So what we have here basically is a fulcrum, a pendulum, with a weight on one side and a magnet on the other. It's kind of bent in on itself here, so there's several fulcrums. But what's happening really in this case is, as a weight is applied to the pan, and this lever is pushed down, what the balance does is apply current to this force coil, which then pushes the weight back up again, and that's how balances determine a weight. But let's just look at another scenario. Let's imagine we just change the current here, but we don't put a weight on. So effectively, we're pushing at this end rather than pulling at that end, or the other way around, whichever way you want to look at it. The effect is the same as putting a weight on. We're just changing the stability setting here at this force coil. And what that gives you effectively is the net effect of putting a weight on the pan. It's not a real weight, it's the effect of a weight. But in terms of what the balance sees, it sees exactly the same as if you're putting a weight on the pan. So here's a more simplified version of the beam, of the weigh cell with a coil here. So I'm going to show you some experimental data now. This data was presented at the Japan Analytical and Science Instruments Show last year when these balances were launched in Japan. They were launched in Japan before they were here in Europe. And we're going to show three examples of determining the minimum weight automatically using ECL with three examples. One with no airflow, one with a wind speed of 0.7 meters per second, and another with a wind speed of 1 meter per second. And what we're going to show is a comparison of determination of standard deviation and minimum weight using ECL in comparison with a real weight. So this is the setup, yeah? Fume cupboard, we've got one of our environmental monitors here, and the balance with the fume cupboard sash in front of it. So the first data point is comparison of a 5 gram weight with no wind speed over it. So we did three sets of repetitive weighings using a 5 gram weight. We have a standard deviation of 0.4 milligrams. Using ECL, which has the net effect of around a 6 gram weight, we get a standard deviation of 0.45 milligrams. So very close correlation there. So what happens then when we turn the wind speed up? The wind speed now is 0.7 meters per second. The fume cupboard is open slightly, and we're seeing about less than a 3 milligram zero point change in 180 seconds. What we're seeing now is 5 grams, the average standard deviation is 0.87 milligrams, whereas with ECL, the standard deviation is 0.76. So again, pretty tight, pretty close correlation. Finally, if we now look at the data with a wind speed of 1 meter per second, with a fume cupboard sash open 20 centimeters, if you look at the weight 5 grams, we get a standard deviation of 1.6 milligrams, where with ECL technology, we're looking at a standard deviation of 1.4. So again, pretty close mapping. And if you want to look at that as a mapped out data, you can see we're showing good correlation between a weight and our ECL technology. So, the question everybody's going to ask me now is, what does the US Pharmacopeia think about this? Is this an approved method? The answer is no, we haven't gone through that process yet. The way to think about ECL checking is the same way you use internal calibration. So we all have balances with internal calibration, which we use on a regular basis. But you still need to get your balances calibrated every year by an external body. It's the same with our ECL technology now. ECL is something that we can use in real-world examples every day, but we would still need to check it from time to time with the traditional method. What we're giving you, though, is another tool. That link, I won't show it now because of time, but if you want, we have a standard letter which we can send you, which actually explains in a bit more detail, you know, how the regulated bodies are viewing ECL right now as a technology. So, if you want to cut to the screen, I'm actually going to do a live demo now of ECL. So I'm going to press and hold the mode button. And now we've triggered the ECL process. Now it takes about 90 seconds. So I've now got to fill for 90 seconds. But in reality, what we're seeing now is effectively the system applying the ECL variable load about 15 times. And if I make a bit of a wind disturbance over it, that will for sure affect the result that I get. If I make a little bit of vibration, that will for sure affect the result that we get as well. So this is something you could literally do at the start of the day, come in the morning, set it running, go and get a cup of coffee, come back, and the result will be there waiting for you, showing you the calculated standard deviation and the recommended minimum weight for the system. Has anybody got any questions just while we're letting this process run? Okay. The balance we're talking about is one of our new Apollo series, known as this particular model is known as a GXA. The GX models have internal calibration weights that will calibrate automatically on temperature changes in your lab. There's also the GFA, which is the same balance but without an internal calibration weight. And for that reason, is a little bit cheaper. We're a trade-only supplier, folks, so we don't supply directly to laboratories. We supply through authorized distributors, many of which are actually here today at this exhibition. So if you wanted to know a bit more and wanted to get some idea of prices and quotes, we can certainly put you in touch with the local distributor for your area. So hopefully now, in the next 10 seconds or so, we'll come to the end of the process. So it's now saying end. It's saying pass. So the balance actually is usable in this environment. If I'd have really overdone the wind movement, or if I'd have vibrated the table, it would have said fail. You can't use this balance in this environment. So there's the calculated standard deviation, 3.71 milligrams. This is a 4 kilo balance, and I was giving it a bit of external interference. And there's the minimum weight, 74.2 grams. Again, high because of what I was doing to it. So now we now have the option to say, do we want to accept that? If I say yes, what I've now got is a balance that will tell me if I weigh anything less than that minimum weight. I can still weigh on it. It's not saying you can't weigh on me. What it's saying is the result that you get might not be as reproducible as if you weigh something a bit heavier on this balance. Can't quite get there yet. It was 70 grams, I think. So, as I say, the balance is, if we can come back to the presentation, thank you. So it's the GXA models that have the, and GFA that have ECL built in. There's some idea of prices. So we tend to be in the sort of middle range of manufacturers of prices compared to some of our competitors. We are one of the top three balanced manufacturers in the world, but our price position is very much value for money, high quality, long warranties. So in summary, A&D have patented some new technology called ECL, which is really helpful for checking accuracy and performance of a precision balance in real-world examples in your lab. It takes into account local environmental factors that may change regularly and not just the stated factory specifications. And it's a technology that can work hand in hand with USP approved methods in a pharmaceutical or biotechnology type laboratory. Thank you very much for your time, folks. We've got 3 or 4 minutes for questions. If anybody would like to ask any, or come up and see me, we're actually on booth G15. So we have more of our balances there for you to have a look at as well. But if anybody's got any questions, happy to take them there. Just a question here.
Is it possible to offload all the data that's been used in those calibrations offline to a database, etc.?
Yes, it is. So we have a software product called WinCT, which is a free product, which basically is a data capture product which allows you to get data from the balance into a computer, into a spreadsheet, into that kind of world, certainly. Any other questions, folks? In that case, thank you very much for your time. Come over and see us and see on G15. Thanks very much.